This afternoon's highlights will begin at the University of Taipei Diving Pool in Taipei City. It was the women's 3-meter springboard finals. 12 women from around the world qualified for this event. After a preliminary round and semi-final round, it was the Ukraine's Victoria Caesar who was in the first place. However, she would not medal in this final event. First up, we will watch the Republic of Korea's Suji Kim. Kim would attempt a 2.5 somersault twist pike with a difficulty level of 3.0. Watch that one again. Watch, she just rotates a little bit too far. Her feet make a bit of a splash on the way
the
in, but she
seven,
does end with a total
half,
of 309.9. She's good enough now for the bronze medal.
Brooke Schultz.
Next up is the USA's Brooke Schultz. Brooke, in this final round, would attempt a reverse 2.5 somersault pike dive. Again, the difficulty level at 3.0. Schultz was ranked 8th after the preliminary round, moved up to 2nd going into this final round, and at the end of this one, she would end with a total of 323.05. You can see with these slow motions, kept the pike nice and tight, couldn't get her feet back around, made a bit of a big splash as well. That dive did get a score of 72, and she would end in the second spot. Now for the gold medal winner of this event from Mexico, it's Arencha Chavez. Chavez would perform a forward 2.5 somersault, 1 twist pike dive, difficulty degree 3.0, but she does it with almost perfection. Beautiful entry, you can see there as she comes back up. Let's watch that one again. Keeps it tight, able to rotate. Goes straight into the water. Absolutely beautiful execution. That dive scores her 70.50, puts her in first place with a total of 327.85. Chavez takes the gold, it's Schultz earning the silver, and in bronze, it's Suji Kim from the Republic of Korea. Chavez also won the gold in women's synchronized 3-meter springboard and a gold in the mixed synchro 3-meter springboard at this year's Universiad. And back in 2013, she also won a bronze in this exact same event, the 3-meter springboard. The Mexican athlete also competed at the 2012 Olympic Games alongside Suji Kim, who was the youngest athlete in the Korean delegation at those 2012 Games. The men's platform diving event, as well as the mixed team event, will wrap up diving here at the 2017 Summer Universiad tomorrow.
Please give a big hand for all our medalists. Congratulations, divers!
Welcome now to Taipei Arena for the semifinal matchup game in women's basketball between the home city team Taipei taking on Australia. In the quarterfinals just yesterday, Taipei beat Team Canada 76-67, and on the other side, it was Australia that beat the United States of America 76-69. The winner of today's game will go on to play in the gold medal game, and the loser will play for bronze. It was Taipei that had the first offensive possession, not able to score the ball, and that led to a transition bucket by Abigail Weirong, who started the game off for Australia. She would end this matchup with 19 points, shooting 100% from the field. It was Taipei that went on a 6-0 run, and with a slow transition defense by Australia, allowed Taipei's Chen Yingyu with an easy layup. They lead now 8-2. Oz used their height now. Got it inside to Darcelle Lee Garbin to tie it up at 16 apiece. Garbin would end the game with 18 points and 13 rebounds. On the other end, Chen answered with a 3-ball from the top to take the lead back for the home team. The lead changed 10 times in today's matchup, and you can see here Australia going to take it back and feed Garbin right down the middle. Use that tight to extend the lead to 4 midway through the second quarter. And heading into the halftime break, a jumper by Chang Yi-Hu helps Taipei secure the 38-34 lead after 2 quarters. Australia would kick it off now in the third quarter. Great ball movement by this team in the green jerseys. A nice kick out now in the corner to Weirong. She sinks it and brings Australia now within 1. Now just under 6 minutes left to go in the quarter. A nice pass by Alex Wilson to Lauren Scherf as she dives through the key. Ties the game back up. Scherf ended the game with a team-high 21 points and 17 rebounds. As Taipei tries now to regain the lead, it's Australia's Alex Wilson with a fast break bucket of her own. Now, with 30 on the clock in the third, Taipei's Chen Yang-Yu loses the ball, but it's picked up by Hyung, who drills it from the elbow to make it a 1-point game at the end of the third quarter. In the fourth now, Australia using their size once again. They get it into Sherp, who stays strong, keeps the ball high, and goes off the glass to bring Australia the 67-63 lead. Taipei's Hyung Lin Chu answers with a deep three ball of her own from the 45. At 3 minutes left now, Taipei up by 168-67. It's Darcy Lee Garbin that drills the answer 3 from the corner. That one is good, and Australia regains the lead. Then a backdoor cut gets Chen wide open under the hoop to give Taipei 2 points. They now trail by 1. 1 minute left to go on the other end. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Weirong drives to the hole and lays it in for the 5-point lead now. A little miscommunication at the end of the fourth quarter. Australia will take the last possession of the game, and they come out on top, 79-74. With this victory, Australia will move on to play in the gold medal matchup. They will play the winner of Japan and Russia. And Taipei will play in the bronze medal game. They will go up against the loser of the semifinal game between Japan and Russia. Both those games will be played on August 28th. We'll move outside now to the athletics arena. First up is the women's 20-kilometer race walk. 21 athletes competed in this long race, but it was one athlete from the Ukraine that would come out on top. At the very beginning, it was China's Zhang Xin who led the way, but at the 8-kilometer mark, it was the Ukraine's Ina Kashina who took the lead and never gave it up past that point. Halfway through the race, she had a time of 49 minutes and 23 seconds. As she approaches the finish line now, she is absolutely all alone, even lapping some of her competitors behind her. The only one now approaching the finish line for the last time, and it's Ina Kashina that wins the gold medal in the women's 20-kilometer walk. China's Zhang Xin wins the silver, and Finland's Elisa Nuvanen takes the bronze. Next up, the men take to the starting line for the 20-kilometer race walk. It was 3 Japanese athletes that dominated most of this race, but at the beginning, it was Ireland's Sean Michael McNamin who took the lead, but quickly snatched up by the 3 Japanese athletes, and they would stay in the lead for this entire race. At the 8-kilometer mark, it was Japan's Fumitaka Oikawa in the lead, but by the finish line, it was Toshikazu Yamanishi who came first by a margin of 50 seconds before the second place, Julio Salazar Enriquez from Mexico. The bronze medal went to Japan's Oikawa. Yamanishi ended with a time of 1 hour, 27 minutes, and 30 seconds, and it was Salazar Enriquez in second place with a time of 1 hour, 28 minutes, and 20 seconds. Next up was the women's hammer throw final. First, we will watch Poland's Joanna Fiodoro. In her first throw in the final, she reached 70.34, but it was her fourth throw that you're watching here that went a little bit further at 71.33 and earned her the bronze medal. Next up was Belarus's Hanna Maliszczuk. Her first throw was 72.13, which would have been good enough for the silver as well, but she continued to push herself. Her fifth reached 73.49, and this final throw, 74.93. This Belarus athlete would earn herself the silver medal in the women's hammer. It says she's in second place there. That's because in the first throw for Poland's Malwina Kopro, she broke a Universiad record, putting herself in the number one spot. With a distance of 76.85, she broke the Universiad record that was previously 75.83. Absolutely shattering the record. Watch her technique here. She releases right at the exact right point. Goes for the record and earns herself the gold medal in the women's hammer. Koprin also won a bronze this year at the 2017 World Championships after competing last year at the 2016 Olympic Games. Her reaction is priceless as she watches how far she threw that first hammer. Koprin wins the gold, Maliszczuk with the silver, and it's Fiodoro who earns the bronze. Next up is the women's pole vault final. First up, Portugal's Marta Onofre. On her second attempt here, she's able to clear 4.4. She did have one fault before that on this same height, so it will put her in third place on the season best height for her. Next up is Germany's Anika Roloff. Roloff on this one clears 4.3. She does go on to clear 4.4, but does have a few faults before that, so she will end in second place and earn herself the silver medal. Now it's Belarus's Irina Zhuk. Zhuk competed at the 2016 Olympics, and with no faults, she clears 4:40. On her first attempt on this one, beautiful, with some space, she wins the gold medal with 4:40. All three of the athletes, 1, 2, 3, they all clear 1:40, but because Irina Zhuk has no faults before, she wins the gold medal. Once the competition is over, it's all but love for their competitors. Zhuk wins the gold, Roloff the silver, and Onofre the bronze. We'll head over now to the Taiwan University Sports Center for the first semifinal matchup of women's volleyball here at the 2017 Summer Universiad in Taipei. This matchup will feature Team Russia taking on the team from the Ukraine. To start things off, it's the Ukraine's Katarina Dunik. A bit too strong out of bounds, gets Russia on the scoreboard first, 1-0. Russia then pulls ahead, now 14-6. A nice dig there by Natalia Kropkova keeps it alive for Russia. And Elena Pankova's tip picked up easily by the Ukraine, and a spike there by Dudnik gives Ukraine the point. Then at set point, Pankova serves up an ace that cannot be returned and Russia now leads 1-0. Then in the second game, it was a miscommunication by Russia that gives the Ukraine an easy over, but they can't take advantage of it. As Krakova blocks the spike attempt by Daria Dross, Russia takes the lead now 6-5. Great hand positioning there by Krakova, who scoots over to get there. You can see it just goes right back in, hits drops as she's out of bounds, and that's how Russia now takes the lead. They pull away late in the second, and a sloppy serve return allows Russia to set up for a back row spike. Krakova, though, a bit too strong, and the possession goes back to the Ukraine. Krakova tries to get it back now, serves it up, and it's returned with a hit from Hannah Krychenko. But a nice dig by Daria Resevo keeps it alive, and then the Ukraine's drove tries to end it. But Russia's left side and middle take things into their own hands with a massive block. Now Russia up 2-1 in this matchup. Now Russia leads 5-3 in the third. Droves gets another chance at it. This time it's successful as she takes advantage of Russia's poor coverage. It gets exposed there, and the Ukraine bring it now within one. Then a big spike by Russia is blocked, and their coverage was on point this time. Krakova in the perfect spot to get the ball back up. Again, the perfect spot, and a battle above the net ends in Russia's favor. They take the point now and get to double digits. Let's watch that one again. The nice spike by the Ukraine is dug up, and battle over the net. Russia just a bit stronger. They get the point on that one. Ukraine now serves it up. It's Krakova who gets the spike. It's dug up easily, though, by Anastasia Chernuka, and she gets it right back, slams it down in the middle of the floor. Ukraine now down by 1 in the third. Watch here, such great volleyball IQ. Sees the back row a bit deep, slams it down just out of their reach to take it. Now at match point, it's the Ukraine's Angelina Lazarenko who would go for 3 spikes in a row in one of the longest rallies in this entire game. Blocked and dug. That's the story of this rally here until eventually Lazarenko puts a decisive one down and gets the Ukraine the point to keep their lives going. Now the score 24-19. Russia leading the way, and they're gonna look to end it on this possession. A left side spike down the line does it by Elena Pankova, and Russia wins the match 3-9. Russia now will advance to the gold medal game. They will take on the winner of Chinese Taipei and Japan. The Ukraine will play for bronze. Both those matchups will take place on August 28th. Now it's time for the Taekwondo men's team Kiruji gold medal matchup between Russia and Taipei. Russia is represented by Maxet Aleliev, Bogdan Grechtin, Rafael Ayukev, and Bulat Magomedov. Taipei represented by Hyung Yu Jen, Yang Xianye, Liu Wei Ting, and Yo Chia Shin. Russia gets on the board with 3 points, kick to the body, follows it up with 2 more. 5-0 now over Taipei. Taipei now scores with a quick kick to the body. They go back to back now, 5-4, Russia over the Chinese Taipei, but kick to the head lets Russia up big. Russia now 9-4. Russia really pulls ahead, 14-4 now over the Chinese Taipei as the two athletes go at it. Taipei gets 3 more now on the board. Under a minute and a half left to go now in this final. It's Russia up 19 and Taipei, they've got 10. Russia scores 1 more there. Taipei, 3 more now on the board. It's now 20-15. Yeah! A nice battle there between both countries, 26-19, under a minute left to go. Russia scores one more, kick to the head earns them three. And as the time winds down, it's 32-19, Russia. They're gonna take it 34-20 over the Chinese Taipei. Russia earns the gold in the men's team Kyryugi Taekwondo event. They earn 26 points through attack, 8 through penalty, and at the end of it, with a total of 34, they take the top spot. Now it was time for the women's team to get to their gold medal contest. This one would be between Serbia and Poland. Serbia, represented by Alexandra Radmilovic, Anna Bahic, Iris Vujakovic, and Tijana Bogdanovic. Poland, represented by Alexandra Krzyminika, Magdalena Leporowski, Patricia Adamkus, and Hannah Okuneska. It was Serbia that would get on the board first in this 5-minute round. Serbia would take the dominant lead in this one, 5-0 now, but it would move quickly to be much, much higher. Just over 3 minutes left to go, 10-0 now for Serbia over Poland. Poland still not able to put points on the board. Serbia now continues their dominance, 23-1. Poland still gets 1 point up. 1 minute, 33 seconds left to go. Poland puts one more up, but Serbia able to put a few more now, 32-4. As time runs out, it's Serbia that takes the gold in the blue. 36-5, they win the gold medal in the women's team Kyryugi Taekwondo event here at the 2017 Summer Universiade. Medals were handed out to both the men's and the women's teams after all of the Taekwondo events had wrapped up for the day. It was the men's Republic of Korea and Kazakhstan that won the bronze. Chinese Taipei took the silver, and it was Russia that won the gold. On the women's side, it was Mexico and the Republic of Korea that won the bronze medal. Poland would take the silver, and of course, it was Serbia with the dominant win that took the gold medal. That wraps up all Taekwondo events here in Taipei. Finally, we will head to Fujian Catholic University Stadium for the football semifinals between the women's Team Russia and Team Brazil. The winner of this team will go on to play for the gold medal here in Taipei, and the loser will move on to play for bronze. Russia gets the first shot on net. Great stop, though, by Brazil's goalkeeper, Meike Weber. Now in the middle of the field, Russia called for tripping. It's going to give Brazil a penalty shot. Giovanna de Oliveira sets up top, lets it fly, and it is a goal for Team Brazil. Right off of the hands of goalkeeper for Russia, Tatiana Sherbak, and it's in the top left-hand shelf. Right off of her hands into the top corner, Brazil now takes the lead 1-0. Now Russia on the defensive tries to keep it away from Brazil, but De Oliveira gets in there. Another shot on net is stopped though. Brazil's gonna stay with 1-0. Watch this one again. She just steals it, snags it, gets it in. A great stop, though, by Scherbeck. Now Russia's looking to get some shots of their own. Sets up from top. It's just off to the left-hand side. Watch just how close this was to going in. Chernomyrdina sets up at the crease, lets it sling. The crowd on the edge of their seat, it just won't go. Russia now will be called for another penalty, this time holding, and it will give another penalty shot for Brazil. This time it's Julia Bianchi. Can't get it to fall. It's going to stay Brazil 1, Russia 0. Russia now getting desperate for one. They head one over, but still cannot touch the back of that net. Regular time at an end. Now, in added time, Russia needs to get something in the net. A nice kick by Anna Cholovia. Looks good from here. Everybody thinks it's good from where they're watching, but it's just inches too high over the crossbar. And with that, it's knocked out of bounds. The game is done. Added time comes to an end, and Brazil takes the victory over Team Russia. Russia will still move on to play for the bronze medal, but it's Brazil that will go on to play for gold.